Hey, look, it's an Oreo. Hey, stop moving. I gotta. Oh shoot.
Three.
Line and like look straight. Look straight like this. There you go. There you go. That's a good picture. Look at that.
Everybody, go to scrim. Go to scrim 13. Boom, 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 boom. Suicide. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, wait, what? I actually died. Wait, what?
Hello, blood brother.
Hello, brother.
We're both dead.
Yeah, I don't understand why I didn't instantly teleport me back.
Well, guess what? If we can get up, we can scaffold in the base.
I don't think I have any ladders. Sad times.
We do have ladders. It's you, kid. You're the key to this.
Oh. Why you gotta be so black? Wait, what? Why did I just get banned from Marina? I just joined.
I know, right? Same, dude. You guys are a bunch of jokes. Alright, let's
go. Yeah. Let's go to 10. Go to 10. Hell yeah. Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is all God You know what we should do next round? We should wall off the map. Just build a great big wall. And pretend like we have a small dick and that our hair is orange. Hey, why am I a spectator? Hey, can I get some help? Why am I a spectator? Never mind. Never mind. Wait, why am I down? Why is everything fucked up?
Hey, let's go and kill all the black people.
Hell yeah. Oops, sorry teammate. Didn't mean to do you like that. I'm running. There's still somebody who's not ready.
There we go. No more faggots.
Yes. Almost heaven, West Virginia. All right, we got them trapped in. By trapped, I mean they're all in one area, other than that one guy. Oh, I didn't gas him. Squiggly line.
Faggots!
Hurry! Oh, wow, I am leader. Never mind. I just joined the server.
Fuck.
How am I leader? I literally just joined the server, like, fuck. Oh, look, bud!
To God forever, brother.
Almost hentai.
I like to kill all the blacks, so shut the fuck up.
Alright, does PG want to ready up? Because it always seems like we're waiting on him. Jesus Christ. Like, can we kick PG somehow? Oh, thank you. Oh, Jesus Christ. Protect me. We are the superior team with the superior steel because we only have one black person.
Hell yeah.
Fever. Fever, ready up. Fever. Would you look at that? Do you want to wear cool clothes? Well, Auschwitz was not real. Thank you. One's down over there, there's one more.
Yes! Yes!
Got him. Got him also. Alright, you... Ready up, 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 all
fire!
Marie! Mass wall spam!
Fire Nation has attacked!
Thank you, I kinda trapped myself there.
Hey, I like killing
no trapping yourself. This is not allowed.
Killing yeah, no anime bitches. Traps are gay.
Oh, boys.
MLG Pro! Oh wow, these guys are pretty gay. Do you want to suck some chode? Well, bet you do. Alright, can you ready up? Oh my god, I triple headshot a guy. I triple headshot this guy spamming. Oh wow, that's pretty mega gay. I bled out. Boom boom, ready up. That's me, teammate. Why? No balls! YOLO! Oh Jesus Christ, ran out of ammo. The comeback.
Hello, my friends, you old gay!
Shut up, you gay!
Room, room, beep, beep!
Holy fuck, I think he had lost it.
Beep beep lettuce. Go, go. Beep beep lettuce. Well, fuck you and you're dead because you're stupid. Oh, congratulations, you were officially gay. Roar! Oh, my wall, what happened to it? It's gay.
Execute Order 66.
Everybody get in here. It's a sausage party. Inspect your shitty guns, everybody. Come on, do it. Oh, we're all about to get fucked and somebody has an extra wall. Jesus Christ, I'm super bad at this game. I forgot I changed teams.
Bet.
I fucked Aqua about an hour ago.
Dude, we really care. Like, that's, you're like, hey man, I raided this guy, it's for you.
Yeah, I know, right? You guys wanna come on over?
Are you one of the cool?
Yes!
Do you guys
want to
wear cool clothes? Yeah!
Yeah! Execute Order 66.
Guys, let's literally wall off this side of the map, okay? I'll do three walls, everybody else do your own. Jesus Christ. Oh, hell yeah, you guys are all getting... I'm gonna eat
all your fucking asses to this thing.
Do you want to ready up and not be a faggot? Well, don't
be wrestlered. I want to fuck you in the ass right now.
Oh, wait. Oh, wow, I instantly died. Save me, brother!
Brother!
Dick cheese.
Oh, I lag now!
That's basically what this whole entire round's been, just lag. I mean, at the start of it, I was like trying to see how fast I can tap fire, and I was like, holy shit, this is like about half of as fast as I like, usually can. It wasn't.
I downed one as soon as the round started, and I was like, fuck.
I got like triple a headshot out of nowhere, like peeks out for a second. Build a wall! I built part of my wall. One health. Oh no! No!
Fuck me, brother! Brother! No, you.
Thank you, Dad.
I'm Dirty Dan. No, I'm Dirty Dan.
Guys, come to the stronghold! Bottom right, come to the stronghold, everybody! Do you wanna wear a cool cock? Well, you're gay. Oh, Jesus Christ! You guys should have gone to the stronghold! One way in, one way out. No, I did.
Actually, I really do think I might have to take a
Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. Build a wall! Join me, brothers! Over here, Rithers. Oh, anal beats, help me. What is that? What is that 180 headshot? Just fucking 180 chubble headshots me.
You know, it does make sense. Order 66, execute it, my dudes.
Alright, F1K. You know what we should all do? F1K, we should all do LR30s. It's gonna be fun game. Fun game. Fuck the AKs. What is this recoil on this gun?
You gave a 5-year-old kid a fully automatic gun?
Hell yeah!
I'm not too shooting this right now.
My god.
Oh, I've been gayed. What?
Cold, you're shit.
The fuck?
Yeah, I'm shit with the AK, yo. You're good though. You're good, but you're shit at the same time. Make sense?
I killed one, but then
I
probably killed one.
Did I think kill anybody? Because like, I'm fucking instantly fucking at you.
Yeah, I killed one and then.
Hey, why the fuck am I banned? This fucking arena. Yeah. Literally, I'm fucking banned from the arena. I can't join any.
What, you're playing right now?
The arena. I can't join any team, so I'm a spectator. What the fucking anal beads? Alright, I'm joining another server. Fuck this.
What the fuck?
Shoot a kid in a treehouse. You know what kid I wanted to kill? The youngest daughter in Mrs. Doubtfire. Hated her face. By the time I could get a good shot at her, she had grown up and turned into nothing. There is only one win away. I will not lose my record. Well, killing him should do it. Huh? I can't get a clean shot. And poultry is in the way.
On it. statue and you can throw it at him? What is this stuff?
What's this book?
No, this book is not for you. In it are contained all the solutions to your problems. With it, every fear you've ever had would melt away. Hopes would be fulfilled. Dreams would become reality. Growers will become showers. You do not want this book. Oh, my meatball hoagie's ready next door. The sandwiches are meh, but the cutest guy named Prescott makes them. I'm totally crushing on him. Right now I'm playing it cool, just making little jokes like, the clam chowder looks like a bowl of sperms. You think I'm being too coy, or should I turn up the heat? While I'm gone, don't think about that book, Steve. Don't think about that.
Oh, you know that from our podcast!
Nice! They advance life!
What is this?
Life My whole life. 3 days.
3 days? That means you were born on the 30th. You have the same birthday as Selena Gomez. That lucky duck. She has a belly button ring. You should so get one of those.
I can't. I don't have a belly button.
Now I get it. Excuse me, I must use my wireless telephone right now.
This is the voicemail box of Stephen Anita Smith. I'ma need to call you back.
Steve, I know you clone these girls. If the CIA finds out, I'll lose my job. Now I gotta unclone them. Unclone means kill. Whoops. Unclone means kill. Betty!
Stan!
Don't judge me with just a clone. See? Doesn't even feel pain.
All right, American debtors. Earlier in the episode, Francine made reference to poet Francois Le Matel de Bois Robert. What country did he hail from? The answer is Spain. Keep up your learning, America. Now, Stephen Snot, take it away!
Oh, hey. Hi. Or not. Jesus Christ, I'm trash at this game. Hey, what's your name real quick?
Oh, shit.
Hey, can I get a pickup? I'm just trying to start out. Could I just have that sword back? Because you sort of started that fight.
No, sorry. I just lost, like, 50k stone to this guy. And, yeah, I have one health, so I can't.
Aw, man.
Gay.
Hey, you're getting raided. Thanks for showing me where your base is.
No problem, man. It's fine with me. I don't have anything inside this base. It's all the Zerg bases over there.
Dude, I just killed you with all your stone, by the way. I know you have shit.
Oh, yeah, because, you know, there's the giant... You know the one to the near me, the giant Zerg base that's also mine? The one that has the walls around it? I was going to use that to make the other giant base next to it. You see, it's like got a star. It's only got like one layer to it.
Yeah, okay.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah. Uh-huh.
Oh, wait, did you say despawn all this stuff because I don't really feel like playing on the server anymore?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, despawn it, no balls.
You're right, I'm not a trash player. I'll let you guys offline raid me, it's fine.
Yeah, but we're gonna offline raid you.
Yeah, I know. I'm a piece of shit, yeah.
That's all I care about is offline raiding.
I know. Hey. I got 1 HP, by the way, so just, you know.
Yeah, you killed me. Why'd you
yeah,
kill me?
I killed you because your friend, he kind of, you know, took like 50k stone from me.
No, I'm solo.
Yeah. I killed you because it's a hard world. And I'm pretty sure you're not solo because that guy literally...
I just quickly built up this base. I'm trying to get a level 1.
Yeah.
Well, I'm like inside the base too, but like, you know. It's just, like, I don't really want to go out here when I'm like crafting like a crossbow or something, because that's honestly the best weapon. Like, this is my best weapon.
Well, it's just farming at night in that case. Alright. I mean, just FYI, if you think about raiding my base, because I don't believe you're solo, because I think you know that guy, I transferred everything to the Zerg bases, and it's fine if you guys do, to be honest here.
You killed me, I haven't done anything to you.
I know. It just, this game is full of liars, so I'm just presuming guilty until proven innocent, okay? I have like 20 hours also, now kill me. Kill me.
Spanish worksheet.
You really want
I'm sorry. I guess I did want to be king of the nerds. I'd rather have Snot Happy than be king of anything.
I want Snot Happy too, Steve! But it's too late now. Snot won't take me back after you revealed Jenny was faking it to them.
True, but I think I just found a way for you to make him feel like a man again.
You fill me in over a couple of beers. Great, right? I have two party balls implanted in my chest. One light beer, one regular.
Jesus Christ.
She loved you, and you were about to have sex with her. That's closer than any of us have ever gotten. Yeah, it is, isn't it? So, Steve, what should we do now? What do you feel like doing, big guy? Maybe we should go to 31 Flavors. That sounds great. You know, things aren't so bad. I've got good friends, and I realized I can get over the death of a girlfriend really quickly.
Ooga chaka, ooga chaka, ooga 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 chaka. Fine with that. This and the other three Zerg bases are all mine. That's fine with me, like I was saying. I have three other Zerg bases, that's why they're all spread out. All three of these Zerg bases are all mine, so I don't really give a shit. That's why loot is distributed, so you wouldn't get worth 12 rockets. Hey, come in this little peek hole. Over here, come back, come back. Come back. Gay, come on, come back. Holy shit, this is actually a pretty good place. Gay, come on, come back. Jesus fucking Christ. I want gay. Thank you.
charged with burglary. He was later commended by the Fort Lauderdale City Commission for his heroic actions. That's all for today. Let us know what you think about the stories in the comment section below. Don't forget to like us and be sure to subscribe for more stories like this. Get addicted to the good stuff.
YouTube, I'm Landon Dallitzing, and welcome back to another Most Amazing Top 10 video. If you guys haven't already, you guys should follow me on Instagram, at Landon Productions. We're going to be doing huge giveaways for you guys very soon, so make sure you guys go over there. Maybe doing the iPhone X giveaway, I'm not too sure what you guys want, so go over there, tell me what giveaways I should do, and follow me as well, and I'll try to follow as many of you guys as possible. Okay, so enough of all that, so we all know that convicts, well, they're usually in prison because they commit horrible crime, but sometimes these convicts have remorse and are able to change their lives around and do the right things. Well, this is the top 10 convicts who saved a guard's life. Starting off at number 10, there was an attack on an officer at Payne County Jail. An officer was called upon an inmate to use the bathroom because there was none inside of his cell. So the officer said, okay, you open up the door, and then this happened. In his real life right now, this inmate comes out swinging. It's just a 1-2 punch Floyd Mayweather right in your face. The convict was brutally beating up the officer, but the officer was able to call for backup. Little did the officer know that the backup would be another prisoner. Watch. The officer and the convict was able to take down this crazy man. I think it's safe to say that he'll never get another pee break. I mean, I hope he has a strong bladder. Moving into number 9, we have an inmate who helped fend off a convict who is strangling him to death. Take a look at this video. Look at the top right of your screen. You can see the officer being attacked. I know it's hard to see, but the convict was going crazy, and when the officer was attacked, another inmate quickly came to the rescue and helped save this officer's life. This must have been a very scary situation because there seems to be around 40 to 50 inmates and just a few officers, like the ratio. This attack took place at Falconburg County Jail, which is located in Tampa, Florida. The person who attacked the officer was only 22 years old. He seemed so troubled, and something tells me that he's not going to be getting out of prison anytime soon. Another inmate who saved a life at number 8, we're talking about an inmate in Georgia who was out on yard duty outside of the prison fences, but they were being closely watched by an officer. Well, that officer actually fell to the ground because of overheating, and instead of the convict just simply being like, what the? Hey, this is our chance. This is our chance to run. They actually quickly got help and tried to save the officer's life.
Face down, we were breaking a little hard or whatever, and so we went over there. Turned him over, made sure he was okay.
These inmates found the phone in his pocket, and they quickly called 911. They saved his life. Number 7, Texas inmates break out of their cells to save a guard's life. Okay, wait. Let's stop the video right there. How scary is that they were able to break out that easily? I mean, they could break out at any time. Well, an officer passed out, and the inmates decided to break out of their jail to help this officer who seemed to be just sitting there lifeless. The inmates were able to radio for help, and when help came, they just simply just went back into their jail cell. I think it's safe to say that these inmates just saved a life and should be rewarded for it in some way. But I guess not all the time in life you're rewarded for good deeds. Number 6, we have another group of inmates who were on work duty where an officer was having a heart attack. And again, instead of easily escaping the prison, they saved the officer's life. The officer fell to the ground and was gasping for air. An inmate was able to clear his pipe and then pulled out a piece of gum that was stuck in his mouth. And then they started CPR. The inmate who saved the officer's life seemed to be a really good guy. Now, at number 5, let me take you guys over to the county jail in Tampa, Florida, where prisoners outnumber officers 60-1. It's very scary on the officer's side. So it's hard to really keep track of every single person, you know, where they are, what they're doing. Well, take a look at this video where this prisoner attacks an officer just out of nowhere. This prisoner was strangling this officer to death, and then this happened. Right now, it looks like a riot is about to happen. So many inmates running toward this officer, I would be mortified. I'd be terrified. Well, these inmates actually came to save the officer's life and not to attack him. They were able to save this officer's life. This just shows you how dangerous it could be working at a place like this. All right, number 4. Okay, what you just saw was an inmate attacking this officer. The inmate was able to get a strong hold on this officer from behind, and it looks like was 2-on-1, but that inmate was on the officer's side. Both of them together was able to take down this attacker. After he was taken down, another inmate comes in and calms the man down. The officer was able to get away. The officer then gets his handcuffs, so it was able to put it on the man safely. Number 3, we have Antonio Brown, who was supposed to be sentenced up to 5 years behind bars, but he found himself saving a female guard's life. His sentence was reduced to a get-out-of-jail-free card. Antonio was released from prison because of his good deed. Antonio noticed an officer was being attacked, and he went after the attacker, saving the officer's life. This guy is a total hero. This raises the question, did Antonio Brown deserve to be released from prison?
Well, I want to thank you personally on behalf of the judicial system for stepping in and probably saving this corrections officer's life.
So this was the same judge that sentenced him before to 18 months to 5 years in prison, but because of the heroics from Antonio, the judge gave him a second chance at life. So let's just hope he doesn't mess it up. At number 2, we have a teenager who saved a cop's life. This right here is 17-year-old Jamal Rutledge, who was sitting in handcuffs at Fort Lauderdale Police Station after being booked for criminal mischief and burglary charges. Well, his arrest officer was sitting in the same room as him when he collapsed on the floor. The teen took notice of this, and then he quickly started yelling for help. And he started to kick the door to try and get the attention of the other officers to try to save his life. Well, it worked. Officers heard him and came in running. A defibrillator was used to jumpstart the officer's heart. Without this teenager sitting right there, that officer would have died. When the officer was better, the convict and him actually took a picture together along with the other officers who came in and saved his life that day. Okay, finally, at number 1, I have a crazy one for you guys. Back 2012, at Lee Correctional Institution in South Carolina, 120 inmates gathered up their prison handmade weapons and started a riot. They took an officer as hostage. This was a tense standoff, and it was actually a very scary situation for that officer to be in. At any moment, his life can be taken. From the outside, there was nothing anyone could do. If a SWAT team entered the jail, it was likely the officer's life would have been taken. But amazingly enough, there was an inmate inside the prison who called the authorities on the outside using their contraband cell phone, and they told him where they were hiding the officers, which was in a closet all tied up. And they told them where the convicts were, so the SWAT team actually decided, with that information that they were able to gather, they were able to safely go inside the prison, save the officer's life, and restore the prison back to normal without the riot. Well, they attempted this, and it worked. They saved the officer's life. And for that cell phone, I bet you no one really looked into it to find out who the owner was or who they spoke to on the phone, because they probably just let the person keep the cell phone, because why not? Well, there you guys have it. Thanks for watching this video. I'll see you guys very soon in a new one.
Table of father, I asked why. He said, everything that's going on with the police, the verdict and case, I feel as though if I pay the tab, I can make a difference.
The officers say they went over to thank the family and took a photo with them outside the restaurant.
Everything going on in the country, it's nice to see that people out here are still grateful and appreciative. Let all of us know that people still care.
They expressed to the officers that they just wanted to
just a puzzle to solve.
Hey, I brought some food. Ooh, for Rooney. Hey man, I just bring food. Why did you have to do that? Now you're gonna kill me again.
Sorry.
You guys live around here?
Were you the ones raiding?
Oh, I'm not the one raiding. I thought you guys were the ones raiding.
Were you the ones raiding?
Oh no, I thought you guys were.
No.
What's your name? Because I know one of you guys.
Thanks for the food, though. I was starving.
Oh, no problem. I know one of you guys' name is Blett, but the other person, because I'm wondering if I know you guys.
Wait. Repronounce that real quick.
Sukudos privyet. I Blett.
This will
I'm not sure.
Determine your life.
Oh well, I've never heard this thing before, or seen the meme, so I guess I might as well just kill myself.
Oh.
I brought you some med sticks.
I need food.
Oh, I appreciate it, man, but I already have 18.
Look at this. Look at
That's
this.
That's not enough. Jesus Christ. Boy, I wish I was diabetic right now. You want some more food? I can get some.
I would appreciate I'm good, that. Dude. I'm like almost zero food.
All right. Would you prefer, deer, or whatever the other thing is I have? Jesus Christ, why?
Sorry, misclicked.
Dude,
relax,
what's
relax,
your...
Relax.
I'm about to
relax, I misclicked, Jesus. I misclicked one time, I get shit on whole week.
Welcome to my shit shack. Alright, well here's all the food I have. There's 15 deer meat, I think, or whatever it
is. Thank you. I don't need this all. I just have a few pieces.
Are you guys gonna raid my base now that you know where I live?
Here, I have a gift for you.
Jesus Christ. Well, I appreciate the offer. I just don't have any... Holy shit. Never mind. Now I do have a gun. Well, thank you. There's somebody nearby, though.
It's okay.
Here.
I hear you.
Would you like this?
You probably need some ammo, hey? Take some of that.
Thank you.
Alright, good luck, bro.
You too. Is there anything special I can wear to make sure that you guys don't shoot me, like, a certain color something? Just like, just in case I want to help you
guys. Just wear that outfit. We're leaving the area right now, though.
Alright. Bye.
What? Just wear just be naked.
Alright, sounds good. Let me just run around with this stuff.
The outfit I dropped you.
Alright. See ya.
See ya, bro.
That they have the police department's back.
But this isn't the first time something like this has happened. Nearly 1 year ago, Alcorn was among those guarding military recruitment offices after the mass shootings in Chattanooga. Still, there were those who found other ways to show their support, namely cupcakes for the officers.
We appreciate it so much.
Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you. We so appreciate you.
A teenager in Florida who was arrested on charges of criminal mischief and burglary is now being honored for helping to save the life of the officer who was booking him. You can see in the surveillance video, Officer Franklin Fultz filing paperwork on Jamal Rutledge. Fultz suddenly collapses, grabbing his chest. Rutledge gets up in his chair, his hands cuffed behind him, and begins kicking the security door to alert other officers. Fort Lauderdale Police released a statement saying Rutledge's quick thinking was largely responsible for folks surviving the incidents. The team will be honored at a ceremony next week.
2 years ago, a police officer bought a 13-year-old boy some cookies at a City Heights McDonald's.
Officer, it was kind of cool.
That's Jeremy Henwood speaking with Damian Scott on the McDonald's security video. It's the first time they met.
And what you saw Officer Jeremy Henwood do was tremendous, and all of our officers did that. It changed my whole
Wednesday, Scott spoke to 10 News from the back of a SWAT truck, something he probably would not have done before this encounter.
Before he met Officer Henwood, he didn't necessarily have the best opinion of police officers.
Because I was little then, I didn't know the whole backstory. Story. Like, they're killing people and that's so bad, like, I don't like them.
Just a few minutes after Henwood bought Scott 3 McDonald's cookies, a gunman shot the officer. He died a day later.
It's all sad, mad, like,
percentage of the meals sold will go to the police's widows and orphans fund.
It was so much ham.
Hitler's father says he wasn't surprised seeing his son buy a young boy cookies. Scott says it changed his view of the police.
Okay.
Life wouldn't even be life.
And his life is better for it. In these few seconds, Hitler was able to give the boy advice he'll never.
What is going on, guys? I cannot tell you how many of you have requested to see the trunk of the patrol car. I guess because I lacked that in my last video, like, everybody has been asking me, well, what's in the trunk and what's under the hood? So today you are going to get to see what is inside the trunk of a police car. I just got off duty a little while ago and I did not realize how dirty this car is. You know, I like my women like I like my patrol cars. I've got like cat prints and shit all over it. How many cops do you see drawing a dick on their own car? Alright guys, so this is the trunk of a police car. And as you can see up here, I've got my shotgun locked in there. That one's ready to go. Campaign hat, evidence bags, in case we have a shooting and we need to pick up like shells or we have any type of evidence. I have different size bags and different purposes for each one of them. It really just depends on the situation. There's no like right or wrong bag to use. It just depends on whatever call you're out on. Handy dandy towel, because you never know when this will come handy. Evidence kit, and I'll show you that in just a second. Dog food. Dog food is something you will usually see in a veteran officer's car. And the reason why I say that, I cannot tell you how many times this has kept me from getting bit. Dogs love food, everybody knows that. And if you approach them with a handful of food, I guarantee you 9 times out of 10, they're going to love you. So other officers watching this, instead of shooting dogs, give them food. Then of course gloves, I've got my black latex gloves here. Anytime someone's getting bitten, shot or stabbed, or they've been in a fight, anytime there's any kind of blood that's going to be involved, always have gloves handy. Below the gloves, what every officer needs in his trunk, a coat book. Comes in handy from time to time. On this side I have my reflective rain jacket, and below that, my reflective traffic jacket. So I put this on whenever I'm directing traffic. Of course you want to be seen. If you get hit at night and you don't have one of these, it's on you. It's in our department policy that you have to have this on if you're directing traffic. And then these are little booties that you can put on your feet, like if you have a bloody crime scene or whatever, you just put these on over your shoes and they're disposable. You just toss them when you're done with them. And here are my broken spike strips. This is supposed to be mounted up here to the top, but the screw came loose. It's got stripped or something, so it's just kind of dangling here until I can get it fixed. Back here I have my accordion folder, and this is where I keep all my important paperwork, vehicle tow logs, suspended driver's license forms, stuff like that. All the important stuff goes in here. Now the evidence kit. So the evidence kit has pretty much everything you need to process a basic crime scene. You have swabs in here in case you need to collect blood. You have bags, you have tape. And here's your fingerprint powder. This stuff gets everywhere. Comes off easy with soap and water, but it still goes everywhere. So once you dust for prints, you use this tape to pull them off of the surface that you got them on, and then you have to put them on these cards. You put them on the back side of the card, you fill out the front side, good to go. Some of these kits will also contain white powder, and a lot of people have asked me, what is this powder made of? And supposedly it's made from volcanic ash, because it's super, super fine. It goes everywhere, it will go up your nose, you will sneeze when you're dusting for prints. So in this box, let's see, I've got an emergency response guidebook. This basically tells you about like all the placards that you see on semi-trucks or whatever in case there's a serious crash. Before you guys ask, no, they do not expect you to remember all of this. You do have to take a test on it, but they don't expect you to remember it. And in this box, I've got some more gloves. These are actually heavier. These are real thick latex gloves. I've got my traffic wand for whenever I'm directing traffic for a long period of time. These are rain pants, and these go over your uniform so you don't get soaking wet when you're directing traffic in the rain. Back here, I have been looking for this. Crime scene tape. An empty pack of peanuts. More rounds for the shotgun. Another outdated code book. I know somebody's going to ask about the Glock case. There's no Glock in here. I don't keep a spare Glock in my trunk. And then I've just got some like miscellaneous items. Like this is a taser holder. For a taser, I don't even have. I'm going to get this back. More OC spray. And the rest of the stuff in here is just junk.
No, please.
Okay. It's cold outside, wishing that I always could find a friend. Guess who's back, guess who's back, guess who's back.